They literally snatched her off the streets.
Phillip and Nancy Garrido are charged with kidnapping and raping the young woman.
We are now seeing the missed opportunities law enforcement officers had to crack this case wide open.
June 10th, 1991. That was the day this 11-year-old girl was kidnapped from the street outside her South Lake Tahoe home. For the next 18 years, Phillip Garrido, a man already on parole for forcible rape, along with his wife Nancy, would hold Jaycee Lee Dugard captive in this Antioch backyard hideout. Jaycee would bear two children while in captivity.
The man they supervised for a decade is charged with kidnapping and raping Jaycee Dugard.
Shortly after her rescue, federal and state parole agents would face intense scrutiny over how they failed to discover a kidnapped little girl for so long.
Parole records released to KCRA 3 late Friday paint a picture of mistakes and missed opportunities to rescue Jaycee Dugard and her daughters.
You feel like you were scapegoated, kind of made out to be the bad guy?
I felt like I was the one, the representative of all the bad that happened in her supervision.
This is Edward Santos. He introduced himself as Phillip Garrido's last state parole agent, breaking his silence now after 13 years because he says state officials told him he wasn't allowed to defend himself publicly.
Just keep quiet, don't say anything, and hopefully you'll keep your job.
For the first time, he's answering the question, how did you fail on multiple visits to find Jaycee in a tent hidden in the backyard of the Garrido's home?
I looked outside in the backyard, which was a typical, his backyard was like a typical backyard that was it wasn't atrocious, but it wasn't well kept. There was a lot of debris back there. There was just a mess back there. It looked like a junkyard. So there was nothing unusual about that.
Despite the failures, Santos says there is another side of the story he was never allowed to tell. The story of how he played a key role in ultimately getting JC's captor, Phillip Garrido, to confess.
He nods his head three times and says, a long, long, long time ago, I kidnapped her and raped her when she was a child.
The story of that confession began the day after UC Berkeley campus police reported to Agent Santos that Garrido, a sex offender, was seen on campus with two little girls.
I asked him about the two little girls. Where are they? He said, oh, they're gone. They're gone. Their dad picked them up. I go, this isn't over, okay? I need to speak to those two girls' parents. I want to make sure that those parents know that you're taking them places, and A, that they know that they're aware that you're a 290 sex offender, parolee on parole. So tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock, I want you in my office and those two little girls and a parent.
But to his surprise, Phillip Garrido showed up not just with those two little girls, but also his wife and another woman he'd never seen before. He immediately separated all of them. And then?
And I looked over at Nancy and I said, listen, Nancy, I asked Phillip to bring the parents of these girls here today. He didn't do that. If I don't speak with the parents of these girls, they're not leaving this office today. Immediately, Jaycee spoke up. She looked at me and she said, I'm the mom. I'm their mother. And I looked at her and I said, you're the mom? And she kind of laughed and smiled and she said, yeah, I get that look all the time. I look really young, but really I'm 29.
Garrido had a different story. While all claimed Jaycee's name was Alyssa, he said she was the older sister of the girls. At that point, Santos said the women and the girls left the parole office. He ran outside to find them parked in Garrido's car down the block.
Jaycee grabs me by my arm, pulls me back, and says, hey, I'm sorry I lied to you, but I'll tell you what's going on. Without hesitation or anything, she says, I used to live in the state of Utah, and I lived in an abusive relationship with my husband. And I escaped that relationship with my daughters. He was going to kill me and my daughters.
What happened next, according to Agent Santos, would prove pivotal. That's because the littlest girl needed to go to the bathroom. That is when Santos convinced all of them to go across the street back into his office.
Once inside, Agent Santos confronted Phillip with the new information. And that is when he says Garrido confessed. And Santos asked him one last question.
And I asked him, I go, Phillip, if you had to do it all over again, knowing what you know now, knowing that, you know, you could be going to prison for the rest of your life, would you have brought the girls in? And he looks at me and he goes, you know, I would have done things differently, and I would have made sure that I would have never gone to prison.
That is how Edward Santos says this long-criticized state parole agent helped solve a little girl's kidnapping after so many years of missed opportunities.
You know, I tell people the planets, the stars, and the moons were all in perfect alignment on that day. And I am so thankful that you got reunited with your mother and that you're no longer under Phillip's and Nancy's captivity.